Good morning students, I am Prem Singh, your math teacher. I will discuss first chapter. Chapter first. It's rational numbers. Rational numbers, right? Introduction of rational number. First chapter introduction. First of all, you know about rational number. Rational number. What is rational number? A number which can be written in P upon Q form, where Q is not equal to 0, that is called rational number. Right? For example, 3/4, 1/2, -4/5, 6. 6 is also rational number because you can write 6/1, 2/1, 3, you can write 3/1, 4/7, right? These numbers are, and etc, right? These numbers are rational number. After this, I will discuss additive inverse. Additive inverse. Whenever you have to find out the additive inverse, you have to change only sign. You have to change only sign. Change only sign. Right? It means, what is the additive inverse of 3/4? You can write -3/4. What is the additive inverse of -1/2? You can write, you have to change sign. Minus, it means plus 1/2. You can write 1/2 or plus 1/2. Additive inverse of 3, -3/5. You can write +3/5, right? Additive inverse of -6, you can write +6, right? Because you can write -6/1, +6/1, because it's already rational number. -6, additive inverse of -6 is +6, right? Now, multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse. You have to write reciprocal, given number reciprocal. Only write reciprocal. Right? For example, multiplicative inverse of 5/7. You can write 7/5. Multiplicative inverse of 5/7, it is 7/5. Don't change the sign. Only you have to write reciprocal of given number. Minus 3 upon 4. Multiplicative inverse of minus 3 by 4. You can write 4 upon minus 3 or minus 4 upon 3 or minus 4 upon 3. This is right and this is also right. Multiplicative inverse of minus 7 upon minus 5. You know this sign minus and minus, it will be changed. It means this is 7 upon 5 given. But lot of students confuse about minus 7 upon minus 5. They will be right plus 7 upon plus 5. But this number and this number are same. Because minus and minus cancel. So you can write plus 7 upon plus 5. So you have to find out the multiplicative inverse of plus 7 upon plus 5. It means answer is minus 7 upon 5. It means whenever you have to find out minus 7 upon minus 5. Multiplicative inverse of minus 7 upon minus 5. It will be answer is minus 7 by 4. Not plus 7 upon plus 5. Because minus 7 and minus 5. It will be cancel out. Minus minus cancel. So you can write multiplicative inverse of minus 7 by 5. I will give you some questions. You have to give your answer in comment box. Find additive inverse of first 3 upon 5, second minus 7 upon 8, third minus 4, fourth 5, right? And second question is, you have to solve and give your answer in comment box. Find multiplicative inverse of first one 11, second minus 5 upon 4, third minus 9 upon minus 13, fourth minus 6, right? After this, I will discuss about properties. Properties. First property is commutative property for addition, right? What is the commutative property for addition? A plus B equal to B plus A. This is general term of commutative property for addition. 3 plus 7 equal to 7 plus 3. 3 plus 7 equal to 10. 7 plus 3 equal to 10. 8 plus 5. 5 plus 8. So you can say D. In this question, 3 plus 7 equal to 7 plus 3. Which property used in this question? Your answer is commutative property for addition. 8 plus 5 equal to 5 plus 8. Which property used in this question? Your answer is commutative property for addition. Right? Second, commutative property for multiplication, right? Multiplicative property for multiplication, A cross B equal to B cross A. This is general form of commutative property for multiplication. Just like 4 multiply 5, you can write 5 multiply 4. 4 5 is 20, 5 4 is 20. So which property used in this question? Your answer is commutative property for multiplication. 6 into 4 equal to 4 into 6. Which property used in this question? Your answer is commutative property for multiplication. Right? Thank you.